Hi friends, well, welcome back. I want to start a series on this channel where I repaint or make over items from the thrift store. This concept has been floating around in my head for a little bit. I even have a collection of items from the thrift store accumulating in my art closet as we speak. So I really need to get things moving. We are going to start this series right now. And my patient today is this baby blue stool. It's a baby blue stool, not a baby blue stool, right? Okay. I technically did not get this item at the thrift store, so we're already starting this series off strong. I found this stool in my dad's garage, where there's a bit of a hoarders buried alive type of situation brewing.
Oh my god, what is that?
But what is your parents' garage really than a curated thrift store of questionable value?
Oh my god! What is that?
And everything costs the price of your physical and mental labor. So I'm counting this as a thrifted item. And if anyone wants to argue that, I'm sorry, you will be overruled. Right, so I'm feeling called to paint something over this. I don't know if what I have in my mind is really gonna translate all that well, but if it sucks, we can just sand it off and pretend like none of this happened. And are you helping, you think? He's a sturdy little stool. I actually feel kind of conflicted about painting over it because I feel like it's got character, but it must be done. Okay, let's get started. And are you helping, do you think?
All right, here's a better look at what we are working with. I tried to make a little backdrop for these before shots. Looking back, how many close-ups does this thing really warrant, right? I mean, it is a stool, it is blue. Here's my little makeshift photo studio I set up in my kitchen. It's garnering a lot of judgment from the peanut gallery. Then I took Little Blue outside. It does have some rough spots, some uneven paint that I want to sand down before I start, just to give myself a smooth, clean surface. I got some of these sanding blocks, which did not work as well as I thought it would. I thought I'd be able to expose more of the wood underneath. I guess I need a lot more sanding power for that. I did remove some layers though, as you can see. Then I rinsed off all the residue and let it dry outside. It doesn't look much different, but it did feel a lot smoother. It's nice and soft now. Plus, I'm painting it black anyways. This is a new product I'm trying out from my last art supply haul video. It is an ultra matte black chalk paint. Not that I want to turn this into a chalkboard, but I think the look of that, the essence of a chalkboard, is going to be perfect for what I have in mind. So I covered the stool in two coats of that paint and let it dry completely. And then I'm going to use a white watercolored pencil to sketch out my design. I am not confident enough to go straight in with the paint. I do have to draw it on first. The design I have in mind calls for some semblance of symmetry, something I'm not particularly skilled with. So I'm making a simple grid pattern for myself here to make it a little bit easier on me to keep things looking symmetrical. Now I knew I wanted to paint some kind of moth, but I was debating what color palette I wanted to use. I was torn between a lunar moth and a Polyphemus moth. Both good options, but I asked you guys to vote for one on Instagram and the results were pretty overwhelming for lunar moth, so that's what we're going with. Then I mapped out some vines that I wanted twisting around the legs of the stool, like they're growing up from the ground. This was difficult to film since I had to reposition the stool a lot, but you get the idea. I'm bringing those vines up onto the top of the stool surrounding the moth. What I really like about using watercolor pencils on top of acrylic paint is that if you mess up, you can just wipe it off with a wet towel. It's up there with one of my favorite art supplies. Okay, now I've got my design sketched out. I've also added a cute little moon on top. That seemed fitting, but now we can really get into the paint job. Here is my ye olden tub of acrylic paint, plus some miscellaneous items. This is a new textured paint that I really want to try out today. I have these chrome color shifting type paints that might make for interesting wings. I'm also a sucker for cute packaging. Look at this set of watercolors. I mean, the paint sucks, but I couldn't part with this metal tin. I also have this new set of gouache paints that I'm really itching to use, but I think I'm going to save them for their own dedicated video. Now I'm just deciding on a color palette from the rest of my acrylics. Since the moth is going to be cool tones, blues and greens, I think I want to make the vines in warm tones so they really pop, give some nice contrast. But mostly I just really wanted to use this orange brown suede textured paint. Upon first inspection, it does not look any different, but maybe it will look different in practice. So let's just start laying down some leaves. It is hard to tell on camera, but the paint does have tiny chunks or specks of something in it. You can sort of see the texture a little bit better once it's dry. It looks like there's sand mixed in with the paint. It also feels like that to the touch. Really, I'm wondering if this product was intentionally made like this, or if it is defective reject paint that they repackaged and rebranded for chumps like me. Either way, I'm glad I tried it. It's different. I don't hate it. For the second coat, I'm going in with a darker burnt orange to give the leaves a little bit more dimension. And once I'm happy with that, I can go back in with that black chalk paint to just clean up the edges, any mistakes that I made. All right, the vines are done. I went ahead and painted the legs off camera. It was hard enough finding the right angle to paint them in myself, let alone trying to also film it. Now we're gonna start working on the moth. I wasn't fully set on what colors I wanted to use, so I'm just laying out a selection of different blues, greens, purples, stuff that I can mix together as I go. Some of these paints are very old, very chunky, but I can't get rid of them. What if I need that color? I just mix them with a little bit of water and we make it work. I'm gonna start on the moth's body and lay down some of my darker outline colors on the wings. As much as I would like to make this look like a realistic moth painting, realism is just not in my arsenal of art abilities. I really wish it was, but I've never been able to achieve that style. So I will be taking a more painterly approach, just kind of playing with color, doing my best to convey some whisper of texture, but ultimately it will still look like a cartoon. I know that, I accept that. I painted the moth's antenna in the same color palette as the leaves to sort of tie it all together. Then I'm gonna lay down a base coat of light blue for the wings. This time lapse here is very satisfying to me. Can we take a moment to appreciate it? I tried to paint each segment kind of as its own shape, leaving a little bit of a gap for myself so I know where each one begins and ends. Some of them were ultimately still lost to me, but I tried. I bought this baby USB powered fan specifically to dry paint projects faster. It's great if you're impatient like me. I don't like waiting for things to dry. Next, I'm going to layer in some different blues and greens, blending them in with that first color, really with no real rhyme or reason, just kind of building up some different shading, making it look a little bit more interesting. Then I outlined each segment of the wings with a very light blue. This highlighted some of those areas that came out kind of uneven, but that probably only bothers me, to be honest. Looking back at this footage now, I feel like the wings looked absolutely just fine, but in the moment, I felt like they were missing something, so I started adding little flicks of color everywhere. I kind of wish I would have stopped around maybe, I don't know, this point, but my too much gene kicked in and I couldn't stop. I kind of covered up all that nice blending work I did, but it's fine. It's conveying like a post-impressionism or something. Okay, filling in some of the details, I'm tying in the yellow with the body into the color of the moon. And then speaking of doing way too much, I added some kind of artful looking mushrooms to the bottom of the legs. I'm finishing those up, and then the last thing I'm going to add is some stars into the background. Now, I do actually use this footstool as a footstool. Odie also likes to stand on it sometimes when he's practicing his circus act. So to protect the paint job from bumps and scratches, I'm gonna add a few generous coats of a clear matte varnish. If you have a pet at home, make sure that some of their hair settles into the varnish while it dries, so a piece of them is encapsulated in your art forever. This is very important. I also felt compelled to include these shots of me peeling the dried paint off of my palette. This is so satisfying to me. This is why I love acrylic paint. Does anybody have a craft project that they do with scraps of dried paint like this? Let me know, I might be interested. And here we have it, the completed stool. I had a lot of fun painting this. It was way more relaxing than some of my previous projects. I also think it gave me a little boost of confidence to do more standalone paintings. I'm pretty pleased with how it turned out. I think it looks way pretty. My boyfriend has lovingly dubbed him Moth Gideon, but we do need to ask the resident art critic what he thinks of my piece.
Hey, Mom. What do you think of Mama's stool? Bub, what do you think?